In this video, I'm going to teach you how to use Claude Computer Use, even if you're not a coder. I've never coded anything before. I was able to do it. And with this video, you will be able to do it too. At least that's my goal. The first step is we are going to go to docker.com and it's going to look like this. What we will then see is a button that says download Docker desktop. Docker is an app that will allow Claude Computer Use to run within what they call a container. So it's a safe environment for the AI agent to run and to do whatever it is that you prompt it to do without getting access to all of your computer, all of your IP, all of your data, and putting you at a serious security risk. So what you will do is you will click download Docker desktop. If you have a newer Mac, an M1 chip plus, you will click Apple Silicon, and then an older Mac, Intel chip. For Windows, I'll put something on the screen to help you navigate which one. And then if you have a Linux. So I have a Mac and it's newer, so I'm gonna click that. Then what will happen is this will pop up. You'll click in the Google Chrome, the up arrow or download unverified file. And then what you're going to do is you're going to drag Docker to your applications. Once you do that, it says copying Docker to applications. And then you'll see the launch pad here. You'll click it and then just navigate to Docker. You'll click Docker and it will open. Verifying Docker. Docker is an app downloaded from the internet. Are you sure you want to open it? Click open. And it will look something like this. Now you know that everything is working well if you're logged in up here. And if you click this down below, you click it and it will say the name of your computer and then a percentage sign. So that's what we need from Docker. Now we're gonna go to anthropic.com/API. Then what you will do is click the bottom left button that says start building. You're gonna click that. And then you will either continue with Google or put in your email. I'm going to continue with Google. I'm going to click continue with Google. You will see a screen that pops up that asks you your name. And you'll put in your name and it will also ask you, what do you want us to call you? You'll put that in and then you'll be taken to a screen that looks like this. Once you're at a screen that looks like this, that says good afternoon and then your name, and it has write a prompt, generate prompt, improve, get API keys, whatever. You're gonna click at the top right of your account and then go to billing. Now to start using Computer Use, you're going to have to put some credits on your account. So here you will click complete setup and then you'll answer some of the questions that it's asking, like what type of entity is Growth Academy? Where is it located? Will Claude be used for internal purposes with external customers or both? What tasks will Claude be used for? And then will Claude be used to provide legal, medical, or financial advice, yes or no? And then will you be incorporating our API into any products or services intended for users under age 18, yes or no? Continue, and then you would put in your billing information. Now you could start with $5 worth of credits or $10, $25. I don't care what you start with, but the minimum that you could start with is $5. Now for context, I've done about 25 prompts so far with this, and it has taken less than a dollar of usage. There's also a toggle that you could turn on where you could actually control whether it's replenished or not once those credits are used, and where you could limit the usage of the credits. So maybe you want to limit it to up to $100 a month. There's those controls in there as well. Once you add the credits in here, it will actually show $5 or $25, whatever you add initially. You'll see that added right here almost instantly. And then you're going to click dashboard. Now what we're going to do is we're going to click get API keys. You'll be taken to a screen that looks like this. And then you will click create key. A screen pops up, keep it on default, and then you could name it. So non-tech entrepreneur. Just, you could put your name, you could put a nickname, doesn't matter. You're gonna click add. It's gonna provide you with an API key and you need to put it someplace safe where you will know where to access it. So this next step, really pay attention because it will differ based on the type of computer that you have. So as you can see here, I have a MacBook, so I'm going to use this instruction. If you have a Windows terminal, you would use this. And then if you have a command prompt Windows, you would use that. Now, because I have a MacBook, the only thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to copy and paste my key inside of the parentheses right here. I already bolded it for you. So I'm going to paste. And as you could see, my key is now in the parentheses where it said insert key. Now I'm going to copy this. I'm going to go back to Docker and I'm going to paste it. So I'm going to paste and click enter. Once I paste and click enter, it will say the name of my computer again with the percentage. And then what we will do is we will copy this code and I'll put it in the description as well. So you copy that code, you go back to Docker and you paste it and you click enter. When that happens, you'll start to see things like download complete. It'll start to show that things are happening. And then when it's completed, it will provide us with a link that we will click to go use Claude Computer Use. Okay, started successfully. Now, eventually, once you see the end of the code, you're going to see Computer Use Demo is ready. Open a link to a browser. Once you open this link to the browser, all you would have to do is prompt it here. For the purposes of this video specifically, we're going to try a prompt that says, find me a Christmas tree that is full size on Amazon for $300. Once we click enter, we will see that it responds and it says, running agent. You know that it's working because the running agent sign will start spinning. It will also keep a recording of the screenshots that it has. So you'll see screenshot and you'll see it perform on the right. So it's going to open Firefox. And then from there, it's going to go to Amazon and it's doing this by itself. And it'll take a second. It'll snap the screenshot. And from Amazon, it put in 7.5 foot artificial Christmas tree under $300, which is crazy. It starts to search and snap Christmas tree screenshots on the left-hand side. It'll record every single one of its clicks. It identified one. So it brings one up on the screen. That's 6.5 feet. It's $113. National Tree Company artificial full Christmas tree. This green Dunhill. It records that screenshot on the left. About a minute in, it provides me with a note. I found what I believe is the best option for you, the National Tree Company 6.5 foot Dunhill for artificial Christmas tree. The price is currently $113, well under the $300 budget. Includes a sturdy stand, which is actually amazing for that price. Free returns, free delivery, and it's made by the National Tree Company, one of the most reputable artificial tree manufacturers. Explains a little bit more, and then it says, would you like to see more details about this tree, or would you like me to show you some other options or different styles? And it did this in less than a couple minutes. And so welcome to the future.